Hello again, folks. It's Barry with Barry's 8-Track and Classic Car Radio Repair, and this demonstration is going to be on a AM 8-Track out of a 69 T-Bird Landau Coupe. Pretty cool little radio. It's an AM 8-Track unit. This is not a conversion. It's just a repair to standard stock. And this one was sent in by Bill of Little Rock, Arkansas. And now this model has a couple of little quirks that I'd like to go into just briefly. I've mentioned in quite a few of my videos, especially of conversions, that I don't reuse the original fader, the front rear fader, and it's because its design is self-destructive and a lot of them don't work anymore. And so I've prepared just a little rudimentary drawing here. Let me turn this iris down so we can see what's going on here. Now your fader control, naturally you have, let's say for instance, this goes to your left speaker, this goes to your right speaker, and then this is the output of your amplifier, and then you can adjust, you know, all the way counterclockwise is going to the left speaker, all the way clockwise goes to your right speaker. And you'll notice that this fader has the same problem that this customer's fader has, is there's a break in the resistance wire. And so what that means is not only is there a dead spot in the fader, but it's only going to make contact at either extreme. It's not going to really do anything in the middle here because that circuit is broken. So the only way to get any sound out of the fader is to adjust it on all the way one way. So that just kind of that's just kind of a perfunctory illustration of my point here, and we'll demonstrate that when we go to test the unit too, which we're just about ready to do. And then there's another interesting little design quirk on this unit is this unit has an extra green wire coming out the left side. Now that wire's only purpose is to eject the tape. If you press this leftmost button, you want to press it kind of lightly so that you don't change your station. If you press on this button lightly, it'll pop the tape out, and it'll also pop the tape out when you turn the unit off so that the tape's not, you know, resting against the playback head the whole time that you're out of the car. I don't really consider this this little circuit here, this circuit is always hot even if the car is turned off, because this requires a straight 12 volt feed from the fuse block before the ignition switch, and so that way when you turn your ignition off, it senses that the power has been cut to the unit, and then this circuit will pop the tape out. In my opinion, it's really best to just pull the tape out instead of using that, because even when the car is turned off, this thing is still energizing a circuit inside there. It's a strange electronic equilibrium type circuit that if it's too much positive or too much negative, then it'll pop the tape out. And for the future trouble it could possibly cause, I'd say it's really not even worth having it hooked up, because it is just unnecessary circuitry that doesn't really need to be there, but it could cause trouble, you know, up the road possibly. So I do have it hooked up just so we can make sure that it works and everything. And now we're going to, now that I've made all my cool points, I'm going to go ahead and turn the radio on. And there's our AM. And now we're going to go to our output level meters. So I can show you that all four speakers are working. We're going to work our balance control all the way left.
Let me throw this
all the way right.
So the backbenchers on cable TV can regurgitate it.
All the way right.
That they do.
That little tone you're hearing is some kind of interference with my video equipment. Okay, now we're going to work our fader, and we'll see what's going on with that.
A single accuser has filed a criminal complaint.
We'll turn our fader all the way front, and you'll notice as we turn it towards the rear,
these events are said to
we don't get a right rear speaker there. We don't get a right rear speaker until
police department.
Until it's all the way up and it makes contact with the right hand terminal. So thankfully, this radio will keep the front speakers going. Even if you have it all the way to the rear, so it's not a real devastating deal there. But it's just something that I felt that I had to point out. Okay, so let's go ahead and turn this up. See, make sure we pick up a couple more AM stations in my area. Should be one around 1400.
That's where Goliath came from.
Okay, there's one.
From Gath.
And needless to say, there's not a whole lot of stuff available on AM in any area anymore.
And that's called Stanford.
So there's the one.
And guess what she does at Stanford?
Why, she's...
The measurement of Goliath
and there's the other
was,
one.
Well, he was somewhere between 9 foot six
and
then 9 foot
back
nine.
To our strong station.
It is a justice system in which the
so this one actually picks up a little bit more on AM than most radios do.
Is allowed to question
even without a conversion. Okay, now we're ready to test the A-track section. And now on this model, this has got like a rocker arm assembly. It's more than a simple spring that holds a tape in place. Let's go back to our unit. And so on this type of model. We need to kind of give the tape a pretty good push to get it in there, pushing mostly on the right-hand side because that's the side that activates the rocker arm. So we'll go ahead and push this tape in. And we want to make sure that it holds the tape in. That this doesn't sound nearly as good as a converted unit, and this is just the limitations of the existing circuitry. Let's go ahead and change tracks a bunch of times. Since I do have this eject circuit tied into the power, we're going to go ahead and eject the tape. We just press this leftmost button lightly, and it pops that tape out so you can get it. And it'll also pop that tape out if you turn the unit off, or actually when you turn your car off and cuts the power to the unit, it'll pop that tape out also. Now you do need to give it a pretty good push to get it locked in on this model. So we're going to turn the radio off. And as you can see, it lets that tape out just enough for you to grab onto it. But just to show that you don't have to have that circuit hooked up, we'll go ahead and just leave it out. We'll turn the unit back on.
And the case will be taken, or it'll go to court.
And the only result of not having that circuit hooked up is that it won't eject the tape. You have to pull the tape out.
You know why they do that? To fool you. It's actually...
Okay, now let's go ahead and try another tape, just to make sure it's going to be consistent from one tape to another. Temptations. Okay, well, let's tape out. Let's try one more. Got some Jeannie C. Riley here, a little Harper Valley PTA.
She...
You should have seen it. The stories of the simple life she's led. Oh, you'll remember even if I forget and sing me not that song.
Okay, I'm going to pull this tape out, and I'll go ahead and...
A huge list of indiscretions.
Hook up that circuit again, that eject circuit, just so we can double check and make sure that it works, that it's working properly, even though I don't recommend using it. It's not going to hurt anything, it's just
crickets.
That...
Nobody
it's
gives
just,
a damn.
It's just
Before
more
that,
circuitry.
She was trash.
It's Mueller. Just more old circuitry in there that could break down and possibly cause trouble. So we'll go ahead and pop this tape
These
back in. Okay, that didn't quite engage that time. We hit our eject. Okay.
Diane Feinstein handpicked.
Okay. And this time I'll turn the unit off to eject the tape. So just so I can show that it is working and all that. It's up to you whether you want to hook that green wire up or not. The unit works fine without it. All you have to do is just pull the tape out. But it's more old circuitry that is not really necessary to use the unit, and it could cause trouble, as I've already said it a few thousand times. So on that note, I'm going to get out of here and get on to the next job, if I can find my face here. This is Barry with Barry's 8-Track and Classic Car Radio Repair. Needless to say, if you have an 8-Track player, either for home or for car use, I'm your guy. You can reach me at 928-533-9666. I do FM conversions on classic car AM radios and even classic car AM-FM radios if you're looking to get a lot more output power out of it. And if you want to get some features like Bluetooth, USB reader, aux input, and stuff like that, you can contact me for those reasons also. My website is in the description below. Thank you very much for watching, listening, and we'll see you next time.